Hi, my name's Jamie. I'm going to do a head-to-toe assessment. I'm going to start with wash my hands. Now I'm going to identify my patient. Hello.
Hi.
My name's Jamie. I'm going to do a full head-to-toe assessment on you. Can I have your name and date of birth?
Sure. Justin Bartlett, February 3rd, 1988.
Thank you. And can I look at your bracelet to see? Thank you. So Justin, I'm going to do a head-to-toe assessment. I'm going to start at your head and go down, kind of inspect and palpate and do the whole nine. Are you in any pain today?
No.
From a 0 to 10 scale, no?
Zero.
And do you have any allergies?
No.
Okay, and do you know where you are?
I am at NEIT.
Okay, and do you know what time is?
Approximately 10:50.
Okay. So the patient appears to be awake, alert, and oriented x3. He appears his stated age and he's stressed for the weather. He has no allergies and he's in no pain. All right, so I'm gonna walk you over to the scale and get your height, weight, and BMI, and then I'm gonna get your waist circumference. Your waist circumference. And when we stand up, I'm just gonna assess your gait. So you can stand up for me. And you're gonna walk on your heels towards the scale. Thank you. Oh, and I'm gonna close this for patient privacy. All right, so you can step on the scale for me. Get down for me. Thank you. And I'm going to close this. I'm going to get your weight. So you can stand back up on it. All right, you can get down. Thank you. So, and now you can walk back on your heels. Yes, walk to the bed on your heels. Thank you. So while you're standing up, if you can turn around, I'm going to assess your spine. So you can touch your hands to your toes. And I'm just going to check for scoliosis, kyphosis, or lordosis. Thank you. And you can stand back up. And then the pelvis is aligned and looks normal. So now you can turn around for me. And I'm going to just measure your waist circumference. Thank you. And now, also while you're standing up, I'm going to test for range of motion. So you can put your arms up for me and circle them. Good job. And you can put them over your head. Good. And then you can lift one leg up. Thank you. And then the other leg up. Awesome. So you can sit down. Thank you. And then you're just going to lift your right leg up. Thanks. And then your left leg. All right. And then kick your right leg out. And then your left leg. And then kick back. Thank you. And then push your toes up off the floor. Thank you. Thanks. Okay. So now, now you can squeeze my two fingers. Perfect. And push against my hands. Awesome. So I'm going to have you stand back up. I'm just going to assess for Romberg. Sorry about that. You can close your eyes and point at your right foot. Thank you. All right. Now you can sit back down. All right, so Justin, can you look at me and smile? Thank you. And stick out your tongue and move it left to right. Okay, perfect. And wrinkle your forehead. Thank you. And push up your eyebrows. Awesome. And can you shrug your shoulders? Good. So the patient's speech is clear. He has full range of motion. I'm going to check your temperature with my forehead. So you're warm, he's dry. To the touch, he's not clammy, or he doesn't seem to be too cold or too hot. All right, now I'm gonna. to start the start of his head. I'm going to look at the scalp, and I'm going to inspect for any infestations, any cuts, sores, rashes, bruises, which there's nothing. I'm just going to palpate for any lumps, and I don't feel anything. All right, and then I'm going to look at your ears. So your ears are midline. I'm going to palpate the pinna on each side for any lumps or sores. And then I'm going to pull back the pen and look in the tympanic membrane, which looks good. And then I'm just going to look for drainage. So now I'm going to look at your eyes. So your eyes are midline. I'm just going to look at your iris, which seems to be white, no jaundice. And then I'm going to pull down your conjunctiva, and it's pink and moist. Your iris looks good. So now I'm just going to assess for his pupils. I'm just going to look right over here. Thank you. And his pupils are round, equal, and reactive to light. I'm also going to test for accommodation. So if you could just follow right here on my pen, just with your eyes. And then you're just going to follow this pen inwards. All right, perfect. So now I'm going to look at your nose, and it's midline. I'm just going to check for any drainage, sores, cuts. Good. And then I'm going to palpate for any lumps. And then if you could just put your finger over one nostril for me and blow out. And then the other one. Good. So he has equal movement through each nostril. Now I'm just going to look at your mouth. So your lips are pink and moist. If you could just open your mouth for me, stick out your tongue and say ah. Good. So the uvula is moving. His teeth look good. His gums are pink. He has no cavities. No missing teeth. So now I'm just going to palpate the sinuses and feel for any lumps. Good. So the patient's skin is clear. He's he's not pale, or he doesn't have jaundice or cyanosis. He is warm to touch. He's not, or cool to touch. He's dry. He doesn't have moist skin or anything. So now I'm going to look at your neck. So I'm going to look at your trachea, which is midline. I'm going to palpate, and I'm going to palpate the thyroid. Can you swallow for me? Thank you. And now I'm going to palpate the lymph nodes. So I'm going to start at your pre and post auricular. Your submaxillary and your supraclavicular. Right. Now everything feels good. I'm just assessing for lumps and bruises. Now I'm just going to check your skin trigger. So I'm just going to squeeze this skin over here, and it looks good. All right. Now I'm going to start respiratory. So the patient's in no distress. He has no increased work of breathing, not using any accessory muscle use. He has he doesn't have a barrel chest. I'm going to listen to each side. I'm gonna listen to 6 times on the front and 10 places on the back. Big deep breath in through your nose, out through your mouth. Now I'm just going to percuss each field. And then I'm just going to palpate for any lumps. And I'm going to do the same thing on the back. Big deep breath. prayer cross on the back. I'm just going to palpate and feel for any lumps. Okay. Now I'm just going to check for tactile firmness. So I'm going to put my hand on the upper portion of your back. You're going to say 99 for me, and I'm going to go down 3 times, okay?
99.
Thank you.
99.
Thank you.
99.
Okay. And now I'm just going to check for thoracic expansion. So take a big deep breath in.
Breathe the back of your body.
And out. Great. So now I'm just going to look at your fingers for any digital clotting. Okay, great. And I'm just going to check for capillary refill over here. So I'm going to squeeze each finger. So now you're going to lay down. I'm going to do cardiovascular now. So I'm going to lay you down at a 45-degree angle. Okay, sorry. Perfect. All right. So if you could just turn your head to the right for me. Thank you. So I don't see any JVD dissection. Can you turn your head to the left? All right. So there's no signs of JVD. I'm going to listen to the neck for Brewy. So can you turn your head again? Thank you. All right. Can you turn it the other way? Thank you. So there's no sign of Brewy's, no swishing. So now I'm going to feel for all your pulses bilaterally. So I'm going to start your temple. Okay, and I'm going to feel each carotid individually. Okay, and then I'm going to go to your brachial. And your radial. Skip the femoral. I'm going to feel for your popliteal behind your knees. And then your dorsalis pedis. And your posterior tibialis. Now I'm going to check for edema in the legs. So I'm going to palpate. There's no edema in the legs, no edema in the arms or in the hands. While you're laying down, I'm just going to check for capillary refill in the toes. So I'm going to squeeze each toe. Okay. It would be less than 3 seconds if your socks were off, and then less than 3 seconds in the hand. So now I'm going to listen to heart sounds. I'm going to start at your right second intercostal space for your aortic valve. So I'm going to palpate. And then I'm going to go across to your left second intercostal space for your pulmonic. And then I'm going to go down to your third intercostal space for the Erb's point. And then to your fourth for the tricuspid. And then fifth intercostal space midclavicular for your mitral, which is also the apical pulse. Okay, and I'm just going to go back with the bell and listen. So your mitral, tricuspid, herbs, pulmonic, and then aorta. So now I am going to lay you flat down and assess, do a full abdominal assessment. Are you nauseous or vomiting?
Yeah.
Okay, great. So I'm going to lay you down flat. Are you in any pain?
No.
while you're laying down, I am going to first inspect so I don't see any pulsations. Your abdomen's not distended. It's it has a curvature, which is normal. It's concave. So I'm going to auscultate for vowel sounds first so I don't create any false sounds. I'm going to start in your right lower quadrant and go clockwise. And then I'm going to percuss each quadrant. Alright, and then I'm going to lightly palpate. And if he was in pain, I would palpate that area last. Okay. So now, while you're laying down, I'm just going to assess your feet for the plantar reflex. So I'm just going to do a C. I'll use my pen light as a fork. So I'm just going to do a C going around. All right. Great. And I'm going to sit you back up. And do you have any questions?
No.